Airbnb, an app that lets people rent out rooms in their own homes, has banned Jews in the West Bank from using the site. They haven't banned Arabs, just Jews. That's your tip off that this isn't just some business decision to avoid a region in controversy, because you could have two neighbors in the same town. Take Hebron, for example, where there are both Jews and Arabs. The Arab neighbor can still put his home on Airbnb, but not the Jewish neighbor. Same town, same disputed region, but Airbnb is only banning the Jews. Here, let me read their official news release. It's called Listings in Disputed Regions. So they're suggesting this is about the region that's the problem. But again, they haven't banned the region, just Jews in the region. Take a look. We concluded that we should remove listings in Israeli settlements in the occupied West Bank that are at the core of the dispute between Israelis and Palestinians, unquote. Oh, so it's no longer a dispute. It's over. Airbnb has resolved this decades-long dispute. They've concluded the open question. They've decided, in their great wisdom, that the Jews are wrong, and they're wrong to even live there, and the Jews alone have got to go. So I guess it's not disputed anymore if Airbnb has settled this age-old matter. So weird, though, that they're targeting individual Jews and their individual Airbnb listings. So it's not that they object to doing business in the West Bank, just with Jews. Listen to this line. This is just great. Our hope is that someday, sooner rather than later, a framework is put in place where the entire global community is aligned, so there will be a resolution to this historic conflict and a clear path forward for everybody to follow. Got it. So as soon as Iran and Saudi Arabia and Pakistan and Syria and all the other explicitly anti-Semitic countries in the world are entirely aligned with Israel, as soon as that moment comes, any moment now, I'm sure, then Airbnb will do business with Jews again. I note that Airbnb's head of global policy is Chris Lahane. He happens to be a former senior political activist with Al Gore and Bill Clinton. So no wonder that Airbnb is so anti-Israel, but soft on dictatorships. Do you think Airbnb has this kind of BDS campaign, boycott, divestment, and sanctions campaign towards anyone else? How about other disputed regions, say a place that there really is global alignment over who's right and wrong, like Tibet? Tibet was invaded by China. It is absolutely subjugated by China. The Dalai Lama is universally recognized as the legitimate leader of the Tibetan people, but look at this. These are just a handful of the countless listings on Airbnb in Tibet. They love doing business in Tibet. They don't care if it's disputed territory, if there's money to be made there. I mean, seriously, China says it's eternally part of China. They're great respecters of Tibetan civil rights. And who's Airbnb to doubt them? Seriously, Airbnb wrings money out of Tibet, so they're good. Or check this out. I typed in Myanmar, also known as Burma. I typed in specifically the region called Rakhine, where there is, according to the media, an ethnic cleansing going on of Rohingya Muslims now. And of course, Airbnb deeply cares about Muslims, right? I mean, that's why they're banning Jews but keeping Muslims allowed in the West Bank. Well, again, Airbnb doesn't really care about Muslims, not in Rakhine, Burma, and not in Xinjiang province in China. That's a place where the ethnic nationality is Chinese Muslims called Uyghurs. But China hates Uyghurs and has set up mass re-education camps to punish them. So to sum up, Airbnb is shutting down the accounts of 200 Jews in the West Bank. Just the Jews, not the Muslims, because it's a disputed region. And they'll reconsider only when the entire world says it's okay to do business with Jews. But Airbnb is just fine renting out rooms for profit in the disputed regions of Tibet and Myanmar and Xinjiang in China. I bet they even rent out homes that were stolen from ethnic Tibetans and Rohingya and Uyghurs because, you know, Airbnb loves money. This is gross. We need to protest Airbnb and tell them that we can see right through their anti-Semitism. The only place in the entire world that they ethnically segregate who they're going to do business with is in the West Bank. And they only ban Jews, not Muslims. That's gross. Frankly, it's not that surprising from Silicon Valley. a place that has shown it is out of step with Western values every time they're tested. Sign our petition at protestairbnb.com. That's protestairbnb.com. Let's tell them that even though they like to do business in anti-Semitic and racist countries, they shouldn't act that way themselves. Go to protestairbnb.com and sign our petition. We'll deliver it to their headquarters. They need to know that Silicon Valley should be about spreading the best of our Western values to the world, not about importing the worst bigoted practices from around the world. Visit protestairbnb.com. Airbnb will sell your rooms in any dictatorship, even in Tibet, but they won't let Jews in the West Bank do business. Go to protestairbnb.com to tell them that's wrong.